Hi guys, welcome to Charred Blaze Woodcutter Simulator 2013. I would like to apologise very quickly for the fact that I'm not playing with a face cam on. The reason being that XSplit, which I use to get the picture within a picture going, actually doesn't recognise Woodcutter Simulator 2013 as a game. So, I'm just going to let that sink in for a little bit. You'll probably see why, because this is possibly one of the best games ever released. And it just can't handle its swag. So, new game, let's check out the tutorial. Let's look at the tutorial, say, for the map. So here we have a tutorial that tells us exactly how the map is being used. It shows us that there's a map in the corner, and that you can rotate the camera to rotate the map, and that there's a power plant. Okay, so that's pretty useful. I like the look of that. So let's just load ourselves in. Let's just load ourselves into Woodcutter Simulator 2013, perhaps the greatest game ever created. Here we are in-game. You can see already that the trees are around. There's a hill over there. There's some dustbins. And here's an arm holding a chainsaw. And let me just explain movement, because it's a little bit odd if you're not used to it. So, to move the camera around, you hold the right mouse button and then move the cursor, and that changes your view. WASD is forward, backwards and strafe. To turn, you have to change the camera. So you basically have to hold W and walk while moving the mouse. It's a little bit difficult, and it seems like it would be slightly unintuitive, but you get used to it. Now at the moment we're running at 8 frames per second because this game is so brilliantly optimised. It's so amazingly optimised for next gen systems and high end PCs that even my incredible rig can't handle it. I mean, look at these graphics, look at this, look at the textures on the road, look at the way the road segues into the pavement here. It looks like wet concrete, yes, but actually it just accurately emphasises wet concrete. Okay, you know. Look, and here, look at the bins, look at the bins, look how accurately they've represented the bins. So, here is a bin in which you recycle plastic, and here's a bin in which you recycle plastic, and in these bins you recycle danger. Any danger that you find, you just put in these bins. And here's a skip. Because why not? So, let's get right into the nitty-gritty. And you can see the map in the top right corner, that is an authentic map, much like what we saw in the tutorial. So I'm going to click on this little book here to give us a goal. What have we got? The consumption of wood has increased. Help to prevent help to prevent a delay in production and complete the task as soon as possible. So I have to go to lower woods, and I cut down 5 trees in 2 hours 30 minutes, and I get $7,500. This is a lucrative business. Now you'll notice the game isn't completely tough. It does give us a little tree icon in the map there to keep telling us where to go. You'll notice that I am moving at full speed right now. This is me holding down W as hard as I can, and the speed at which I move is leisurely, because as we know, it is truly a dangerous thing to run with a chainsaw. You can hold down shift to get a bit of a boost going, which is advisable. See, I mean, look at all this grass. No wonder the game is running a little bit sluggish. It has to render each individual blade of grass. Look at the way they move in the wind. It just makes everything look kind of fuzzy, like it's coated in Velcro. It's a very happy world. Here's a church. No doubt we'll have to cut that down at some point. Hopefully we'll be able to get to the lower woods, and I'll be able to show you the actual nitty-gritty of the game, which of course is cutting down the wood. And let's just check out the church very quickly. Look at the textures on that. Like, you think Assassin's Creed looks good for jumping off things. Just look at the architecture, man. That's like Renaissance shit going on. I wish I had my face cam on, because you would be able to see my face, and like, my jaw is currently down somewhere by my knees. It's that incredible. Oh, we're actually coming up to a lake, so we're going to take a quick look at the lake. Again, excuse the lag. It's just too good a game. Look at that. There's a little waterfall and everything. Look at it. Look at the way that if you look in the water, don't worry about that. Look at this. If you look at the water, the reflection of the clouds that actually don't exist in the sky. That's amazing. That is magical. Let's go for a little walk in the water. Can I walk in the water? I can't walk in the water. The game doesn't want me to. It knows that the processing power of my computer isn't enough to do that. But that's fine. You know, I can deal with that. I can deal with that. But listen to the music, man. It's like an infomercial. Let's just sit back for a minute. Yeah. Sing it. Yeah. Oh, man. Oh, yes. It's like they're filming Dawson's Creek in the corner. It's just, yeah. Oh, now you might notice over there is a little yellow splodge. That is a marker telling us where to go. So I like how no one is, no one else is around to report that a guy is running around with a chainsaw. Right, so here we are. Time to get down to business. You will notice that certain trees around here have these little yellow bands. And you also notice that as I get closer to the tree with the yellow band, a little radar is popping up in the bottom right. I don't know if you can see that. So what you have to do is, as you get close to the tree, the radar registers how close you are to the tree. And you have to be able to get the most precise cut possible. So you align the dot into the center, and then you press space. Guys, you better, if you are wearing a hat, I suggest you hold the fuck onto it. If you are on a seat, get on the edge of it. Just brace yourself. I'm going to press space, and you better be fucking prepared. Here we go. Oh, yes. First cut. I'll move the mouse down so you get a better view. I'm literally not doing anything. My hands are off the keyboard. Look, that's me clicking my fingers. I'm doing nothing. Look at the arm graphics. And then, with second cut complete, that's beautiful. Excellently done. And then the third cut, I don't quite know how my shoulder is working here, but doesn't matter. Oh, look at that. And then we get to be rewarded with a beautiful FMV. Forget whatever you've seen in Skyrim. This is graphical fidelity here. Timber! And the tree falls majestically. And then, the best bit. Instantly limbs itself. I don't know about you guys, but I would. And I bet I know what you're all thinking. You're all thinking, Charles, this is an amazing game. Look at this game. How much did you pay for this game? Was it £60? £50? Dare I say a budget £40? Well, my friend, I picked up on sale for a mere £5.99. £5.99. You would have... It just blows my mind that a game of this quality... We're gonna chop down this tree now. The game of this quality, graphical fidelity, of this. I mean, look at the bird in the top there. You see that? It's going past the menu icons. You'll see it go between the menu in a second. Unless it disappears. Look, see that? Watch the bird go past over on the left there. All the processing power to create that one bird. It's not just creating the graphic of the bird, guys. It's not just like a polygons of an animation of a bird flapping its wings. No. The game codes an entire family history, a backstory, names. That bird is called Flapsy McKenzie. And Flapsy McKenzie, we can check in the game's README files, has a whole family tree going back centuries. You can trace this family back to the Civil War, even. Now the game gave us 2 hours 30 to complete this quest. Notice I say quest rather than task, because it is, if anything, a quest. Not much unlike the search for the Holy Grail, to be honest. So we've had 2 hours 30 to complete it. We've currently used 7 minutes of that time. So the game is fair. It's fair. You'll notice also that the yellow ribbon is reflected in the lake, despite not being actually possible for it to be. Here's the "you are not in the right position" meter, which appears whenever the radar isn't properly aligned. Because if you're standing like too far away from the tree, right? If you're standing too far away from the tree, you just won't cut it. The chainsaw will miss. If you're standing too close, you'll hit it with the handle and you won't get any cutting done at all. And let me tell you, that's just ridiculous. You want to be able to get clean cuts. And look how I can cut through the wood, but I can't cut through the yellow band. Yeah. They do think of everything. That yellow band is... That's why it was put on the tree in the first place. It marks which trees are to be cut and can't be cut down by rival loggers. Which are a real problem, I'm led to believe, in this small mountain town. So once again, tree falls. I guess I've got two more trees to limb. What I'll do is I'll take those ones down, but I'll do it in fast forward because I know. Sorry, I know you're sitting there clamoring to see the full effect of the last two trees being cut down, but I just think we need to get on. So we'll do it in fast forward. You guys can enjoy yourselves. Task completed! We completed a 2-hour 30 mission in 10 minutes, guys. I'm just too good. Too fucking good.